sponsored or something that was less. And so I'll give you a bit of history on how we got to our flavor plasma. My talk is called The Path to More Viable Plasma. So how many people here know what plasma is and who's heard of it? Me, okay, thank you. How many people know what OmiseGO is? Okay, not terrible. So I think we can start there. This one, the big green button. So what is OmiseGO? So we are a public peer-to-peer permissionless payment system, payment platform, and we see ourselves as a decentralized exchange. That's what we're trying to build here. Because when we think about payments, we think about exchange of value. And if we want to try to build a platform for universal payments, we sort of have to think about it as a universal exchange. And so that's kind of a core piece of what we're trying to build here, is this decentralized exchange. And so what we are is the technology that underpins it is this layer 2 blockchain. And how many people are familiar with layer 2? Do you guys know? Okay, great. I know you guys know. So when we think about layer 2, it's all referenced to layer 1. And when we talk about layer 1, it's the main blockchains that we all know and probably love. It's things like Ethereum, Bitcoin, the first things that come to mind. Layer 2 is a way to transact value that exists on those layer 1 blockchains in a concurrent manner that's secure. And so the flavor of, or the security method that we're using, the construction that we're using, is called plasma. And so I think the next question here is, what is plasma? So what we have on the slide here is, it's a way to build scalable blockchain applications. So what does that really mean? So let's start with what we know about blockchains. Well, we know blockchains are cool. I think that's why we're all in this room. And by cool, I mean they exhibit certain properties that we all find really interesting, right? So they're permissionless, they're trustless, they're public. These are all things that in blockchain, but we generally talk about them under an umbrella that people use the word decentralized. So there are these decentralized properties that make blockchain really cool. The problem is that blockchains are slow. So I think Anthony touched on today, just now, that Bitcoin operates at, or Ethereum operates at something like 12 to 20 transactions per second. I think Bitcoin's at like 7. And then when we talk about payments, we look at something like Visa, and they're pushing somewhere in the tens of thousands. So this makes it difficult for us. So what can we do here? So since blockchains are slow, can we make faster transactions outside the blockchain and report a summary back to the blockchain later? And so the real world model of this, when you think about it, is something like your credit card, right? So we think of your bank account or your regular banking system as layer 1, and we think about your credit card as layer 2. And so you can do transactions on your credit card more frequently, faster, and then periodically you go back and you settle back to layer 1. You settle to the bank account, you make payments, things like that. And so there are a lot of real-world applications to this where you don't care about intermediate states, you care only about the final state, the settlement state. There are things like microtransactions or IoT, where you really only care about how things land at the end. Or one thing I actually really like is games. You don't care about the intermediate state of games, you only care about who wins or loses. And so plasma is a way for us to do this. And plasma is part of a family of technologies that people generally know as layer 2 scale. And so basically, with layer 2 scale, what you do is you transact with layer 1 value for cheaper, hopefully, and at higher bandwidth. And I specifically didn't say faster for those who know about blockchains, because we are limited by the finality of the root chain. And then we periodically confirm those changes back to layer 1. And here's one of the key pieces, one of the things that we really like about blockchains is that we trust no one. So we maintain the trustlessness of the construction. So how do we do this? So what is plasma? So like I said, plasma is a layer 2 scaling solution. It was proposed by Joseph Kuhn and Vitalik Buterin, and Joseph Kuhn was the author of another layer 2 scaling solution called Lightning Network, which is generally described as HMS. And then Vitalik Buterin is the creator of Now, for the people out there who are technical, plasma is really a design pattern. And this is a misconception sometimes when people talk about plasma. It's not a specification, and it's not an implementation. It really is an idea of how to scale a project. And plasma is also under heavy research by multiple teams around the world. So it's still very, very much in development, including at OmiseGO. So here's the basic idea. I'm going to give you a basic overview of how plasma works. So we start with our root chain, and we have a root chain contact. And so for us, our root chain is a thing. And then we have this plasma chain. And that's the chain that we are operating. And so one thing I'll note as we get into the, for the talk later is that the consensus mechanisms of these two chains do not have to match. They are agnostic. So to use our plasma chain, all we have to do is deposit funds from the Ethereum chain into the root chain contract. And then the plasma chain operator basically creates those funds on the plasma chain for you to transact. So now you've held the funds in the root chain. You can now transact all you want on the plasma chain over and over again. Now, what makes plasma special, what makes it different from what some of you might have as side chains, is that the trustlessness piece is dependent on this step here. So for every single block of transactions that we produce on the plasma chain, we submit a hash of the state of that block back to the root chain. And so what that means is a hash of the state is basically a snapshot, a compact snapshot of all the data that happened in that one block on the plasma chain. And the way we do that, for you nerds out there, is we use Merkle roots. And so that is the root of the binary hash tree, basically. And so that's really the key innovation in what makes plasma interesting and what makes plasma secure. So you transact all you want on the chain, and then you exit. And so all you have to do as a person who is operating in this plasma construction is talk to the root chain contract with the information that you have, and you can get your funds out. And so this is it. This is basically all that plasma is. It's 3.5 steps, let's say. You deposit, you transact, the hashes and states of your transactions are logged into the root chain, and then you exit. And now, the important part about the exit is that you only have to have a personal relationship with the root chain contract to exit. And this is what keeps your value secure, and this is what keeps it trustless. Because if there's anything that goes wrong in the plasma chain, including us getting hacked or malfeasance of any operator, you always have an opportunity to go back to the root chain, which is something that we believe in, like Ethereum or Bitcoin. We believe that it's going to operate correctly, and we believe that it has all the security, and you can go back and exit your value. And so this is what makes plasma special. Plasma extends the security of the root chain over the plasma chain, and it's because of this model of us being able to hash the state back to the plasma chain, back to the root chain contract, and also exit through that root chain contract. And so that is a very neat characteristic of plasma chains versus other side chains. So let's talk about what plasma is not, and this also gets confusing for people. What plasma is not is, like I said, it's particular specification. There are a lot of plasma specifications, or as people call them, flavors of plasma looking around right now. And plasma is also not a smart contract platform. I think that was a misconception early on in the plasma days that you could potentially run Ethereum smart contracts on plasma. It's not a smart contract platform because of the specifics about how to maintain exitability. Remember, we went back to the idea that the exits are what make you safe. And so when we talk about smart contract execution, you have to sort of figure out who owns that execution and who is able to exit that. And that is hard to define on a general basis. It's much easier to define on a very specific application basis. So now you're probably wondering, like, what are the plasma specifications of how to get there? So quick overview of the families of plasma. There are two main flavors of plasma specifications. There's this idea of a fungible plasma and a non-fungible plasma. And I imagine there's a bunch of Fintech people here, so fungibility is something that people generally understand. But basically, the general idea is that when you deposit funds into the root chain contract on a fungible model, it goes into a big pool of money. And the value that we create on the plasma chain is basically your earmark, your claim to that money in this big pool. The non-fungible forms of plasma treat your deposit as this like little unit, this little special unit that you can transact with on the plasma chain. And so there are limitations to how that works, and there are some advantages and some really interesting problems when it's non-fungible, but it also creates its own usability problems. I won't get into the non-fungible stuff because that's not what we use, but I'll leave that up to the viewer. But we operate in a fungible plasma, and the specifications that we've built on, one is called MinimumViable plasma, and that's the one that Vitalik proposed. And then we built on top of that ourselves, and we called it MoreViable plasma. and also leave it up to you to understand the games that the platform community plays with their games. So let's talk a little bit about minimum viable plasma, which is what we're looking at. So it's fungible, it's a single plasma chain, because that's where the state of technology is right now, the research. It's a UTXO-based blockchain, so if you're familiar with blockchains, UTXOs are a way to represent value in a blockchain, and because of the way that the protocol manages security, UTXOs are much simpler to reason about when we're trying to exit. So it's a UTXO-based blockchain. The way that we guarantee security is through this distinct exit priority. And so basically, when you're in a plasma chain, anybody can exit at any time, including bad actors. The reason that you're safe is that as a good actor, your exit will happen before the bad actors do. And so as soon as you see something go wrong, you put in your exit, the thing that goes wrong will exit after you do. The contract empties out, but hopefully the honest participants first, and then everyone's left over the back. And so one key characteristic about minimal viable plasma is that it includes this thing called confirmation signatures. And again, for the technical people out there, the reason we have confirmation signatures is to address the data availability problem. And so we treat transactions on the plasma chain as optimistic. So we assume that we treat them as pessimistic. We assume that transactions are not valid until the sender sees them mined and reported back up into the root chain. And that's the way we guarantee security. And so confirmation signatures are a solution to data availability, but they seem cumbersome for a payment network. Because basically, when you make a transaction, you have to basically wait for something to happen and then send another transaction. So we invented a new thing called MoreViable plasma. And so it's still fungible. It's still a single plasma chain. It's still UTXO-based. But we changed the way we do exit priorities because we took out confirmation signatures. And so now we treat transactions as an optimistic. We assume all transactions are valid by default. And so the way that we handle the security of that is that we created this new thing called the in-flight exit engine candidacy. Now that is a lot of words, I know. But basically, it's a recourse. So you send a transaction, we assume that it's valid, and then we have this trigger economic process that you can converse with the root chain and basically get your money out without involving anyone else. So that is MoreViable plasma. So where are we today as OmiseGO? So we fully implemented MoreViable plasma for payments, and it supports Ethereum and ERC20 tokens. We're currently on our second public alpha platform release, and we call that network Samurai. It's named all after BPS solutions. And we would invite all developers or any partners that are looking to play around with our network, interested in integrating with our network, to come and try us out on this public alpha of ours. And of course, as I mentioned up top, we're developing our exchange features. So if you want to learn more, you can go to developer.omisego.co, and here's all our relevant contact information. And I am Kasima Thakurpichai, and I'm pretty much, you can find me at Kasima pretty much everywhere. Thank you very much.